Anyone who's had a baby knows how stressful both pregnancy and the first few years of any child's life can be.
Well, recent headlines have suggested that one of the best ways to control anxiety and keep calm is to practice yoga, both during and after your pregnancy.
Well, Cheryl McDonald, a perinatal yoga teacher, is here now to show us how. And, I mean, hello, welcome. Hi. Lovely to meet you. I'm a big yoga fan. I do yoga twice a week since being pregnant. I think it helps more than anything in the world. But it is something that more and more people are doing.
Absolutely. I mean, yoga is for everyone, especially pregnant women. So, you know, during the perinatal period, we're having all sorts of physical changes, anxiety about childbirth, you know, coping with very little sleep, discomfort, all these kind of things. So the properties of yoga, so yogic breathing and postures, can help with all these physical and mental discomforts as well. So it's absolutely brilliant and suitable for everyone.
So the benefits are just playing with the light.
The benefits
just
are
make sure that's not hot.
Thousands of benefits, but mainly during this period, you know, preparing for childbirth, so releasing anxiety, building up strength and stamina in the body, but also bonding with your baby at every stage. So even when they're in utero, all the way through to when they're mobile, like these wee guys at the back.
You go on your own though, don't you?
I do. I quite like. Funnily enough, at the kids' nursery, they do yoga at nursery, and I know as sort of toddler age, they really love it, but I quite like the sort of selfishness.
Oh, no, absolutely. Yeah.
I quite like that sort of escapism moment. But the breathing, I think the breathing's a really important thing. Yeah. Just something as simple as that is so powerful during
It really is, labor. And yoga itself, translated, means union of body and mind. We make that union using the breath. So breathing techniques as well can lower stress levels, can help release oxytocin, which is a love hormone, which actually makes us fall in love with our baby as soon as they're born. So it has so many benefits.
How soon after you've given birth can you start your yoga?
Okay, so postnatally we're looking at about 6 to 8 weeks postnatal for a normal birth. But C-section you're looking about 8 to 10 weeks.
A little bit later. And it's just with everything with yoga, it's just so important to listen
Absolutely. So it's definitely not a case of no pain, no gain. It's about whatever is comfortable for you. So we have this posture, it's called cat cuddles or vidalasana, so it's really nice and easy.
Yeah.
Mum's going to come onto all fours with a nice flat back. Okay, so hands under the shoulders, knees directly under the hips. We're going to exhale. Then we're going to inhale. And on the next exhale, we're going to gently curve the spine up, looking towards the navel, if we can still see it. And then we're going to gently curl back down. Now, this is fantastic for releasing the entire length of the spine, the neck and the shoulders, but also gently tones the abdominal muscles, and it's one of the few ways that you can do that when you're pregnant.
It's quite Pilates, isn't it? It's like the cat in Pilates.
Yes, everyone has that similarity, but
hang on a second. If he's a bit, he can go out there. Maybe he wants a glass of drink or something.
When you get stressed, yoga's supposed to be calming.
There you go. That's all right.
And obviously, yoga with baby doesn't always go to plan. So.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
And have you been doing it for a while?
About 3 or 4 months now.
And have you noticed the difference?
Yes, definitely.
It's sort of mentally, you feel calmer. I mean, it said that it reduces the fear of childbirth, cuts anxiety by a third, this report, and after 2 months of classes, stress hormones are reduced.
Yeah, it's certainly the breathing definitely helps when you're sort of thinking about childbirth and that sort of thing.
Okay.
Definitely helps mums have a positive attitude and looking forward to childbirth as opposed to dreading it, because we know it's not easy. So it's hard work and recovering from that postnatally as well.
Next stage.
Okay, next stage when the baby comes along.
Yep, so this is Suzanne and Bobby, and they're both postnatal. So postnatal yoga can be done with or without baby. So Suzanne's going to demonstrate without baby and Bobby with.
Right, okay.
Okay. Now this posture is called Virabhadrasana or Warrior One. We're going to take the feet about 3-4 feet apart, front foot to 90 degrees, back foot to 45, just aligning the heels. We're going to take the knee, so it's just above the ankle, and just turning the hips gently forward. Then we're going to take the hands above the head, and we're just going to look up towards the third eye, so just between the eyebrows.
And what is this beneficial?
Up to the what?
Up to the third eye, so just between the eyebrows.
Ah.
All right? So just looking up to the sky. This is fantastic, obviously, for strengthening the legs, rebuilding the body after pregnancy as well. Fantastic for opening up the shoulders, the chest and the heart for breathing. Another nice thing about it as well is we can engage the pelvic floor, which obviously goes through a lot of pressure during pregnancy, and the Uddiyana Bandha, or pulling the navel back and up, which makes you stand nice and straight.
As you're talking.
That's it. So careful when you're pregnant doing it, but just pulling back and up. And this helps to rebuild the pelvic floor and the abdominal muscles nice and gently, because lots of people jump into sit-ups and crazy workouts, but you don't want to do that.
No.
That's detrimental.
Slowly, so work, but surely.
Work with the breath. Mum's got a lot of lower back pain as well, okay. So this is really beneficial for that gentle back pain.
All of these, of course, we can only just scratch the surface on what we're doing here. There's so much to do. We'll just give you a taster, and we'll put all the details on the website. Let's move on to
and
our
also, so mum and baby here, because obviously
yes.
Not everybody can disappear off and go and do a yoga class, can they?
No,
so
absolutely. Hello. Absolutely. So this is a really nice opportunity, mum and baby yoga. I think you should always try and practice with baby where possible.
It's so sweet.
It's so good for bonding as well. So you're making eye contact with baby.
Yeah.
You're talking to them and telling them, you know, what we're doing together. So what we're going to do here is called baby boogie. So we're going to take one of baby's arms and the opposite foot, and we're going to give it a stretch. I'm going to stretch out, not pulling the arms and legs out of the socket.
Why do little perfect things that arrive beautiful and brand new need any work on them?
Right, okay, so people will say, why baby yoga? That seems bonkers. But actually, yoga postures, adult yoga postures, are based on the movements of newborn babies.
Babies kind of do it naturally anyway.
They do.
If you look at a baby,
absolutely.
They sort of sit there and you go,
oh, they're on their backs and grabbing the tails.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
Sort of
so when we practice yoga postures, that's what we're trying to return to, the bliss of infancy.
I
physically
think it's just
and
a nice
mentally.
Bonding thing to do. Like, look at look how happy they are. Yeah,
they're
look
very, very relaxed.
Here, this is good for the shoulders, the neck, opening the hips, because babies spend a lot of time restrained and buggies
and sometimes cramped up as
bouncers
well.
And car seats
in the belly.
These days. So these postures, you know, they can help with things like colic, sleeping problems, digestion as well.
Okay, and what about when they get a bit older then?
Okay, so it's a whole different
hello,
ball game.
Hello, toddlers.
This will be interesting. So a whole different ballgame when they become mobile.
Yeah.
And I always say with toddler yoga, what you have to think of is the room or the studio is your yoga mat. So as you'll see, the mums are trying to kind of pull the babies back to the mat, but you should just follow them, go with it, and they'll often show you. They'll say, no, mummy, this is a tree. This is what a dolphin looks like. And they'll show you. So it's about continuing the bonding process, just having fun with it and just
seeing
what happens.
At different levels. Like, this
absolutely.
Boy, my little boy, if I tried to do yoga with him, he'd be running all over the place as well. But
exactly.
Actually, as he's got older, he's sort of further.
Yeah.
It's kind of getting those little moments of concentration. It doesn't have to happen straight away.
Yeah.
It's a tiny, tiny, weeny bit of focus.
Exactly. And I think practicing yoga, especially with a mobile baby, is the most yogic thing you'll ever do, because it reminds you it's not all about you anymore.
Yeah.
It's probably never going to be, and things don't go to plan, and that's life with a baby.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, thank you very much.